Welcome to This Is Our Earth podcast. I am Sylvia Fuentes, and I invite you to these amazing conversations that invite you to the wonder and magic of connecting with our beautiful planet.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode live from El Lugar, as you can hear all the birds in the background, of our This Is Our Earth podcast. And as you all know, El Lugar somehow has this higher purpose, higher than just building a luxury resort and a profitable business. We actually want to invite the world and inspire the world and educate the world on different technologies that we can use on treating the planet, on taking care of the planet, and making sure that future generations will enjoy planet Earth at least the same way we enjoy it today. You've heard a lot what we do different in building. You know, we build all the houses on pylons, we don't seal the land, we don't cut the trees, but we are also looking into cutting edge technologies. And I hope you all remember our rose garden episode with Rafael talking about the treatment plant. Today, I have a very special guest from the UK. We engaged energy efficiency consultants to help us finding cutting edge technologies. You all probably know Liam Bramley, who is the founder of the energy consulting company dedicated to finding and exploring possibilities in being different with the resource electricity. Today, I'm here with Chloe Bramley. She's the co-founder and co-creator of this business and the business manager. And what they came up with for El Lugar is an amazing, unique, and simple technology that heats water with almost no energy. It's thermal panels. It's not the same as solar panels. And these thermal panels are currently only used in the UK to heat water until Liam and Bramley found out about this technology, introduced it to us, and last week they came over to actually install the first 4 thermal panel water heating systems in our houses. And I took a shower, and I can guarantee personally, this shit works. Water is fucking hot. The thermal panel on the outside is freezing, although the temperature here at El Lugar is around 32 degrees Celsius. So I don't understand how that works. But I'm glad to have Chloe Bramley here with me. Welcome, and thank you so much for finding and introducing this technology. Well, Chloe, can you explain in simple words to people who are clueless about physics, how can you create energy and heat by just putting some panels out in the air?
Well, hi everyone, hi David, thanks for inviting me to speak on this. It's not often I get the opportunity actually, because Liam's so excited to talk about the technologies that it's hard to get a word in edgeways.
Well, unfortunately Liam is out in the fields looking at the next cutting edge technologies we can use. He's looking at air conditioning units where we don't use a refrigerant to cool the air, we use something else, but this will be another podcast. So for now, we have you and your brilliant ability to explain complicated systems in easy words so that everyone out there can actually understand how it works. So okay. Thermal panels, what is it and how does it work?
Well, essentially, we're surrounded by energy, and we're blessed with a lot of energy from the sun, which is in our environment. It heats our earth. You mentioned that the thermo panels aren't solar panels, but they're often described as thermodynamic solar panels, which is a little confusing for people because people know what a solar panel is and they think this must be the same thing, or they don't understand the difference, especially the terminology can be a little confusing. Essentially, the solar element that we're using isn't photo particles. It's the thermal particles, which is heat instead of the sunlight, essentially.
So what you're saying is you don't need sunlight to make that work. Just fresh air is enough?
Yeah, essentially. Environmental ambient temperature. So this technology is becoming more and more known in the UK. And it was really funny to us because the warmer the environment is in which you're operating the system, the more efficient it is, because you're taking the warmth from the ambient temperature around and basically converting it into power to heat your water system, which is the way that is done. Is, if I can get like sort of slightly technical, but not really. I describe things the way that I understand them myself. So you're not going to get a physicist's description.
Okay, go for it, because I really would like to understand, how is it possible? I know there are these heat pumps that turn fresh air into heat by somehow taking the heat out of whatever is in the fresh air.
Yeah.
But this thermodynamic panels, well, just go ahead and share your knowing.
Sure. So most people would be familiar with the way hot water tanks are installed in the home. In the UK, we have either a big hot water tank that is powered and heated by some kind of electricity or combustion. So that's often gas, which is, you know, put on fire. So that's a non-renewable way. You can heat it with electricity. It's usually very energy hungry. So if you're using grid power, which might be coal power, for example, it's using essentially a 15,000 watt energy resource to heat your hot water. This system uses 400 watts. And the way that it does that is because it's not burning anything or using anything up in order to create the heat. Essentially, the panel is like a reverse refrigeration system. It's hard to describe what it looks like. It's sort of a flat black panel that looks like it has little channels through it. And there's a specific kind of gas, which Liam can tell you the name of, that gets put through these panels. And it's got a very low boiling point, this gas, which means that it is really cold as it goes through the panels. You touch it and it's freezing. And
I know, I was touching these panels, and you guys probably saw the pictures of these panels, and we'll put one up. It's just a black panel. And yeah. I touched it, it was freezing cold in the middle of a 32 degree Celsius environment, which was stunning.
Yeah, so it doesn't make sense, right?
Like, it doesn't make sense, not at all.
It's completely counterintuitive to how this can heat water, but essentially because the boiling temperature is so low, as soon as you've got this gas into the environment, it is absorbing the heat from the environment really quickly, in the same way that when ice melts, it's water taking in heat from the environment, and the state of the material or the matter is changing, because the like thermodynamic properties means that it changes its state after absorbing the temperature from the air. And the thermo panels operate in a similar way, in that once they've had their opportunity in the panels to absorb the ambient air temperature, we then have a mechanism to force them back into a liquid. And because of the low boiling point, which is in negative Celsius, the natural consequence of switching it from a gas to a liquid again and forcing that change means that an immense amount of the heat that it has absorbed in the panel comes off. And we're able to utilize that in a heat exchanger to heat water in a tank. And that happens with no power. The only power that's being used is with the pump system to make that happen. So there's no energy consumption from a power source for the actual heat exchange method, if that makes sense.
So what you're saying is that heating up a water tank would need like 15,000 kilowatts electricity. In this system, you only need 400 kilowatts to actually run a pump. And the actual heating process is done by converting gas into liquid. And when that happens, it releases the heat, and that's the heat this technique is using to heat up the water in a tank.
Yeah, precisely. But it's also a closed loop system. So the cycle between gas and liquid and gas and liquid is just ongoing. And you're
so
able
you put
to...
the gas in once. You don't need a gas tank to feed that.
No, exactly. Once it's installed, it's completely maintenance free, which is one of the reasons we're really excited about it, because it's sort of a one-up cost. And then the electricity savings over a year or 10 years is immense. It's one of the reasons it's taken off so successfully, I think, in the UK, is because the UK, because it's a smaller country and a lot of the homes and buildings are trying to use small spaces well, it's not as common to have the water tank in homes and in buildings. So a lot of what happens in the UK is on-demand heating, which is hugely resource heavy. It costs an absolute fortune, and houses are heated through winter with this water circulation that's into the, you know, you touch your
radiators.
And it's heated with hot water. So if you're using it, it's not uncommon in the UK for someone's electricity bill to sort of multiply by about 3 or 4 times through the winter period.
So what is this energy saving? If you have a regular home run on an instant electric power heating, what would that electricity be in the winter, and what would it be if you installed that thermal panels? More or less, just to give our listeners an idea of what amount of savings we're talking here.
Yeah, so without doing precise calculations, just sort of ballpark figures, through the summer when you're not having to heat the house, but you're still using your regular hot water uses for your family, or, you know, sinks, showers, mm-hmm. what have you, you're probably looking at electricity costs running around £80 to £100 a month. Through the winter months, that will spike to, can be up to £300 or £400 per month. And that can be just for a small family of two.
So what would the cost be after installing the thermodynamic panels?
Should be lower than your summer usage, which, because you're still using the hot water in summer, if you're spending £80 at the best time of the year, you're going to be spending less than that through the summer months. So you might, it depending on your other uses in the home of electricity, you might be looking at, say, £60 a month throughout the entire year.
Throughout the year. So instead of going up to £300-400 in the winter, would keep it at £400 at £60.
Yeah. And you know, UK, the winter can be 7 months long, if not more.
So why are we using this now at El Hogar, where there is actually no winter? Well, Costa Rica is very well known for producing 95% of the energy through renewable sources. That unfortunately led to kind of, okay, it's all renewable energy, we can use it without thinking. Yeah. So it doesn't matter how much energy we use, the consumption of energy is not bad, because it was produced in a renewable way. And this is actually where we said, no, we need to teach the world, we need to inspire the world to take that a step further. You can even take into account the environment and the energy consumption if it was produced in a renewable way. So we're actually taking that another level further. Yes, it's correct, it's all solar energy, it's all from biomass treatment plants, but that doesn't give us the right to waste it.
Yeah.
And using instant water heating, 15,000 kilowatt instead of 400, a big step towards kind of being really aware of what our choices create when we turn on the hot water.
That's it. I mean, people often sort of associate renewables with, you know, guilt-free, endless resource, but it's really not that, because if you look at it, you're still having to produce the materials in order to capture the energy that mm-hmm. is that renewables are capturing. So, you know, solar panels and windmills and all of these things they're really resource hungry. So you're using a lot of hard materials in order to get the energy that's required. So reducing at the demand side is a hugely powerful way to essentially, you know, what's the word?
Well, I think you have to look at the whole thing from a bird's eye and look at every direction. And there is no, this was produced in a renewable energy way, I can now waste it. No, it's being that present. And that's what we want to actually invite the world to look at. Be present with planet Earth. Be kind to it and treat it as you were a guest here, because mankind is a guest on planet Earth. And as a guest, you treat your host's home kindly. And that's what we are trying to invite people to. So we are building a village here. It's not just a hotel. So we are a big project. Is this technology available for private home owners as well, or is it just for big projects?
No, it can absolutely be used for essentially any size facility. They're using it for private homes a lot in the UK, and we're hoping to essentially what we've done here with the buildings at Illagar with the casitas, you can think of them principally like a home in terms of the use and the size. So a domestic system can quite happily service the needs and requirements of a guest staying in one of the casitas here. And then it can also be engineered in terms of scaling up for commercial and I would say industrial as well, will be one of the areas that people will be exploring, and we potentially...
Well, we will do it here at Illagar. We already asked you to find a solution for our venue, for the restaurant. So another question is, we are planning on having that, but in the first casitas, the first four casitas were already finished, and then you came and upgraded our system. So it's actually an add-on. You don't have to build a new house to have that system. You could just add it and switch over to it. Is that correct?
Yeah, absolutely. It's designed to be retrofit technology as well, which means whatever you're currently using, you can replace your current system with the thermodynamic solar panel system. Primarily, all you need is the space. And then,
so how much space do you need?
If people can imagine what a water tank looks like, a water heater.
A regular water heater tank for a private home, which is how many liters, more or less? Oh. Is it 400 for a big home?
Yeah, that sounds about right.
So I actually saw it, and it's like 1.50 meters tall, and then it has like a radius of 50 centimeters. It's actually not a big space that you need. And then there's another little box where the technology goes in, and I think that's it.
Yeah, well, most people would have a tank in place already, which the system could actually be retrofit to the tank.
Oh, so you could use the existing tank as well.
Absolutely.
Wonderful.
Which is another way that it's brilliant, because, you know, reducing the use of these resources that, you know, it's finite. These resources are finite on planet Earth.
So. Wonderful. So if I had kind of a second home where I have this electrical instant heater because I don't use it that much, that would be a perfect way to kind of test the system and see if it really works.
Have you got somebody particular in mind?
yes, because I reached out to a lot of people telling them this technology, and they all said, well, amazing, but still they want to test it out. And especially in Europe, I mean, second homes on the countryside, I guess this would be the place to do it. So if our listeners want to find out more about this technology and want to find you, what's the domain they can find you?
We're actually currently setting up the domain because we...
You just started, right? So what will the domain be, and when will it be up?
We've been privately contracting without need for it, but because of the success and the interest that this has created, we're realizing that we're really going to have to.
So if I give them the domain, you would kind of be pressured to start the business. So what's the domain? Give it to us. We'll put it in the thread. And we will release this podcast in 2 weeks from now. So you have 2 weeks to start the business. Get to work, and welcome to the world and change of Illagar.
Thank you.
So what will the domain be?
Branly Consulting.
bramleyconsulting.com.
It would more likely be .co.uk, but we can update later with links.
bramleyconsulting.co.uk or bramleyconsulting.com. By the time you listen to this, it will be up already. You just heard 2 weeks and this will be out. So
no one like David to get a bomb under you. I love it.
Thank you so much for summarizing this complicated technology, which seems so easy, and it is actually easy and it works. Liam and Chloe are living in the house where they installed it. We are testing it every day. We're improving it. Gary Douglas stayed in the house. He took a shower and he is very, very picky with taking hot showers in the morning. He loved it. And his house will be actually the next one to be equipped and retrofitted with this technology. And I think after that is done, I might be able to get on the waiting list with my summer home where I have an instant electric heater and I'm so done with wasting energy when I take a shower there.
We'll do absolutely everything in our power to make sure that happens quickly.
So if any one of you wants to get on the waiting list to test this system, just check out bramleyconsulting.co.uk and see if that is something you would like to have in your world. And if there's anything else you want to know, reach out to us. We are promoting what we are doing here. Remember, the idea of Eloga is to invite the world to different possibilities. And this was just one of many and more to come. So thank you, Chloe, for joining me today. And I can't wait to have Liam on the next podcast about the cooling-air conditioning system that he just found, where they don't use kind of refrigerant liquid to cool the air. I have no clue, but Liam will let us know.
Yes,
thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you for the invitation. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you all for listening to this show. My target is to inspire new actions and conversations that empower all of us to know that we are the ones creating the future. So please share and also visit us at ellugar.com and actionsforfutures.com. Thank you.